I don't know if we're being silly or smart, but nobody else is leaving. Tomorrow's the worst day. Wanted to get ahead of traffic. Thank you, Hurricane Beryl. Let's go down that road. Faithful people, I'm Orlene.
And I'm Gary.
And this video, I almost didn't even bother because I thought, oh my gosh, that's been ages ago since this happened. But actually, it was just a week ago today that we evacuated from Houston. So we want to tell you a little bit about why we made the decision we did when a lot of other people did not. We want to tell you some of the things we had to do afterwards. They had to go back to Houston. Let's just back it up. Okay. We were in Houston, Texas, because I had surgery on May 24th for endometrial carcinoma. I had a complete hysterectomy. I have several videos on that. You can get caught up on that if you want. But the bottom line is, we had to wait till my 5-week checkup to know if everything was healing okay and everything was all right. And then they wanted me to have radiation. And I went through about 2 weeks of going back and forth on that. I have another video on that. You can check that out. I had to wait until the 5-week checkup to know if it was healed enough to start radiation if I had chose to do that. All right, the video that we left you with the last time was that I had just had my first treatment. That was on a Friday on the 28th of June. Then the 1st, the 3rd, and the 5th of July. And on the 5th, I told them, you know, if this Hurricane Beryl comes anywhere close, we're probably going to leave. We're not going to stick around with an RV in a hurricane. And they told us to get to safety, whatever we needed to do, and they could reschedule me for my last one. So they still didn't know when it was going to hit for sure, where it was going to hit for sure. How high the winds were going to be, they didn't know that either. Okay, the hurricane, as it was getting closer to land, was at this point a tropical storm. It had kind of fallen apart. And they kept saying, it's going to reform though, it's going to become a hurricane again before it hits land. And a lot of people didn't seem to be real concerned about it. And so we're like, well, you know, this is our first hurricane. We've never been in hurricane country before during hurricane season. And so we kept watching the news. We kept trying to figure out. We kept looking at updates. We kept turning to different apps that different people who we've experienced were telling us to look at. And nothing was clear. What happened Saturday night that you were thinking we needed to leave on Sunday?
Saturday night we were able to get a little bit of a taste of what was coming. There's a sudden thunderstorm that struck, really loud thunder, crackling lightning. Oh, it was exciting.
A lot of rain.
And the rain you couldn't see across the RV park. It was pretty heavy.
Yeah.
The thoughts of that happening and continuing for hour after hour after hour through the night and into the morning just scared the daylights out of me.
one radiation treatment left, and that was on Monday the 9th. And that was on Monday the 8th. And I thought, you know, if it, my appointment was in the morning, if I could get my appointment and then get out of there, right? Well, it looked like it was going to hit sometime Sunday night. And we just debated and debated, and we talked to other people in the RV park. I said, are you guys leaving? And they're like, no, we feel pretty good. We're all right. We feel like we'll be fine. I'm like, okay. So my introduction, when I said we're being silly or we're being smart, turns out we were smart.
Where else we
were? Yeah. MD Anderson was still scheduling me for Monday because we didn't know what the outer bands of the hurricane were going to be like. So we got out of there about 8 o'clock in the morning. And we didn't know for sure which direction to go, but we knew we should not go east because the outside band on the east side is called the dirty side, and that's a side that's really wicked. And we knew enough that we had to either be north or west of that. And we kept looking at the cone, the projected path of where it was going to come inland. We had offers from several people in Fredericksburg and Tyler and Tom Bean, and which is up by the Oklahoma border, Scroggins. We had offers from all kinds of friends that offered for us to come up there and stay by them. We started out going towards Tom Bean, and then we started thinking, man, if we have to go back to Houston for my last treatment, that's a long ways to go. So we headed for Tyler. On Sunday afternoon, I don't remember what time it was on Sunday, I got a notice from MD Anderson saying that my appointment was canceled for Monday morning. And I texted a woman named Jackie, who was another RVer at the park, was also a patient at MD Anderson, and she was also getting treatments. And I asked her if hers was canceled, and she said no. Hers was after 10 o'clock in the morning. And I'm like, okay. Well, then later she told me it was rescheduled for 3 o'clock in the afternoon on Monday. I'm like, well, I never got mine rescheduled. Mine was canceled. So we just kept going, and we were well ahead of anything, which was good. We weren't sure, because when we left it was raining, and we didn't know if that was the beginning of it or what was going on. It turned out that the rain that we got on Saturday night wasn't even associated with Beryl. So that was really the scary part, because we thought, man, that's just a thunderstorm. What's Beryl going to be? We got out of the area, and MD Anderson still said that things were going to go as scheduled just later in the day on Monday. I'm like, well, we're out of there. That's not going to work. And then they scheduled me for Tuesday morning. They changed my appointment to Tuesday morning at 8:30 in the morning. And I'm like, that's not happening. And I told them that we were in Tyler, Texas. I told them why. And that if we had to come back, that was going to be about almost a 4-hour trip one way. So I asked if we could have it in the afternoon. But I also asked, what is one more treatment going to do? I mean, really. I had 4 out of 5 done. Was one more treatment that takes less than 2 minutes, was it really going to make that much of a difference for my outcome? Well, of course, they said I needed to finish. The storm came close to Tyler. We got a few gusts of wind and got a lot of rain, but not real bad. We were really just on the northern edge of it, as we found out when we had to go back to Houston on Wednesday. Wednesday afternoon, I was rescheduled for that, and we headed out in the morning and drove down to Houston, had my last treatment. They wanted to know if I wanted to ring the bell. I'm like, I had 5 treatments. There are people that are having 35 treatments. I'm not ringing the bell. So I did not. I'm cancer-free right now. We're gonna hope to keep it that way. And in future videos, I'm gonna be sharing some of the extra things that we're doing to keep cancer away a second time. Anywhere, for both of us. So you just have to subscribe if you want to know more about that. Hopefully we're going to get back into more of our travels, which is what we're doing right now.
Yes, we are.
We are no longer in Houston. We did not take our RV to Houston that day. We left it in Tyler and just took the truck and went down for the day and came back the same day. So we left about 8:15 in the morning on Wednesday morning, the 10th, and we came back about 7 o'clock that night. It was a long day.
Houston was a mess.
Yes. We got gas. If you look at our Facebook page, I'll tell you the story of what happened the day of our travels. Gas stations were out of gas. Gas stations were closed because of no power. And we knew that fortunately ahead of time. So we filled up the day before on Tuesday night in Tyler. And on our way there, we decided, well, we'll stop somewhere along the way and cap it off, top it off. And then we'll be good to go the rest of the way and most of the way back. We started seeing long lines already 80 miles out of Houston. And we were a little concerned. But we did find a Love's truck stop 50 miles out. And we sat in line for about 45 minutes. We had allowed extra time just in case, so we were okay. Got to my appointment in Houston in time. There were stoplights that were not working. It was not crazy. But MD Anderson was very busy that day. And because they were trying to make up for all of the appointments that had been postponed and rescheduled and whatever. Anyway, had my appointment. Then we stayed in Tyler. One extra day just to rest up on Thursday. Friday morning, Friday noon. After we said goodbye to everybody, all of our friends there, we headed out and we got as far as Texarkana. And we met up with Mark and Jackie, who are friends of ours that we met through our YouTube channel a few years ago. And they treated us to supper. Thank you again. That was awesome. And then we stayed not too far from there that night, Friday night. The big concern was, how am I going to travel all the way back to Wisconsin? It's been 7 weeks, just 7 weeks since my surgery. They say it could take up to 4 months to feel yourself again. The radiation makes me sleepy. It takes about 3-4 days to kind of get through that. And I was actually feeling fairly good before I had my last treatment. So I'm still kind of wearing off the effects of that, I think. And I still have a pillow that I have on my belly. As we travel, I have it down so the seatbelt goes over it. I don't know if you can see that right there. That helps a little. I still sleep with it kind of on my side too. In fact, I'm a side sleeper, so that's kind of helpful. My energy is much better. I haven't had any pain. No gas pains, but I did have, right after my radiation treatment each time, that by that afternoon and then the whole next day, I feel kind of like achy, almost like menstrual cramps again. And it's like, that doesn't make any sense. But it's concerning. And they told me it's still from the surgery, but I was, before I started the radiation treatments, I wasn't having that feeling anymore. So, I don't know if it's related or not. I guess we'll see how things go here in the next week. And now the travel's in between. But we're headed back to Wisconsin for the rest of the summer, where our kids, three of our kids and Gary's mom and some other family members are all up there. And we'll spend our summer up there, the rest of it. It's gonna be August. Right around the corner. Golly. We're normally back in May, so this is really not the norm. We hope you're all doing well. We know that the RV park that we were at did not have power for at least a few days. It was very hard to get any updates. The person that I knew from the RV park, I was texting her, but I don't think she liked to text, or she was trying to conserve power. I'm not sure. There were no updates on the RV park website or on their Facebook page. There was nothing after the hurricane. So we really don't know how things were. I did check to see what happened in Pearland, because we were very close to Pearland. We used to go and get our groceries and things like that, because it was only a few miles from the RV park. And they got a lot of wind. A lot of wind. So I can just imagine what they all went through, and we just hope they're all okay. It's kind of worrisome that we're not hearing from them or anybody there that we got to know. So do we regret leaving? Absolutely not. We do not feel silly at all. And the stories we heard from people afterwards that live in houses, a lot of them said that if it ever comes similar to that again, they're going to leave too. I just don't know how so many people were so unprepared that live there, that know that this happens. So many didn't have generators. So many didn't have any backups of any kind. If you live in hurricane country, you'd think you'd have those things. I don't know. Wisconsin is tornado country. That's what we can be looking forward to when we get back to Wisconsin. Oh man, we're in a bumpy spot here. Our prayers for those who still don't. For those who still don't have power. And yes, we know all about what happened with former President Trump. We heard about that from several people. We've been watching it. This country is just unbelievable what's happening. So our prayers for him and his family, prayers for the family of the young man who was the shooter. I mean, he has mom and dad, probably. He probably has, maybe he has grandparents, maybe he has siblings. I mean, what's his history? What we don't know. There was so little known about him. So our prayers for his family, because I'm sure they're just completely heartbroken. Prayers for our country. A lot of people to pray for.
Well, the man that died as well.
Yes, right. The one that was hit.
Yeah, there's a man.